love our vets, and we love our Second Amendment. And it was sort of this, like, handsome guy with a wonderful wife, Peggy. Where's Peggy? So Henry was for me from the beginning. There was nobody else. It wasn't like, I supported Trump. You know, some of you guys, I supported Donald Trump very early. Yeah, after seven other people. After the defeat of nine people. They were with me. And they never let me forget. But Henry was there from the beginning. He's a fighter. He's tough. He's strong. And he's a gentleman. He's a gentleman. He's been here with us, and Henry, I'd like to ask you just to come on up. This has been an interesting voyage over here. I've never taken a long trip. I have never taken a longer trip ever to South Carolina.
Y'all Trump fans, ain't you? Kings Mountain, Tennessee? I mean, North Carolina.
No.
Y'all from Kings Mountain, right? North Carolina.
And you know that if a horrible thing happened, and we weren't lucky enough to have Henry win, you know they won't talk about that. They will say, Donald Trump suffered a major, major defeat in the great state of South Carolina. It was a humiliating defeat for Donald Trump. So please get your asses out tomorrow. I said, let me ask you, we have a situation that's very interesting. I'm turning on the television, I see the race, and I say, what time is it right now in South Carolina? They said, sir, it's almost 4 o'clock. I said, oh, I've got to endorse Katie. I said, how many hours are left? They said, like 3.5. I said, maybe I shouldn't do it, because I won't have enough. And what happened? I did. I said, I don't care. I can't stand that guy. I don't. And I like her. She was another one right from the beginning. She didn't talk about other people, right? So I said, okay, so we had like 3 hours, 3.5 hours left, something. I'm just lifting off from Singapore, far away. It's a 22-hour flight. You think that's fun? That's not even fun in Air Force One, okay? When are we landing? Sir, we're almost there. 7 more hours. So good. When they tell you you're almost there, you only have 7 hours left. And by the way, we had a great success. North Korea. Chairman? We're not looking up to you. shot over him in 7 months. There's been no rocket tests. There's been no nuclear tests. There's been no ballistic missiles. They've blown up their site. Today, got no coverage because Snake News doesn't cover. But today, look at all those fake newsers back there. And you want to see a lot of people? Go outside. This is a gymnasium. I said, Henry, I don't work gymnasiums anymore. He said, please. I said, okay, I'll be there. Go outside and take a look outside. You won't believe what's going on out there. So you people understand real estate though. But we have a call, and I have numerous calls with Prime Minister Abe. So happy for the people of Japan. They're happy for the people of China. They're happy for the people, especially of South Korea. And we're happy. And you know what? We did something that was wonderful. And the world is soon going to be, and right now it is already, we have good chemistry. But the world is going to be a much safer place. And North Korea is going to be a much better. So,
that's nice.
Come on.
heave.
Point after point after point. And I did nothing, and this just never ends. Never ends. No collusion, no nothing. But you go, point, and you know what? After the election, I said, okay, let's go. Come on, who cares? Let's go. We're going to make America great again.
Can you believe that? There is nothing he can do.
And she said, he has done a great job. So we're working on it. But there's David Lynch. Enjoy it because his career in Hollywood is officially over. Did you see Jimmy Fallon? Jimmy Fallon.
Cracker.
He was so disappointed to find out it was really good. Well, that's one of the great things I got. Everybody used to say my hair's falling. So my hair. I'm wearing a hairpiece. You know what? Anybody here wearing a hairpiece? But the one thing they never say that anymore, because I've been caught in rainstorms. I've been caught in winds that are like 60 miles an hour getting up. If it's not your hair, don't run for office. If somebody would open a talk show at night, because the guy on CBS is what a low life, what a low life. I mean, honestly, are these people funny? No. And I can laugh at myself. Frankly, my goodness, that'd be big enough. But there's no talent. He's nothing not like talented people. Johnny Carson's talented.
Yeah.
CBS has no talent. Jimmy Kimmel would meet me before the election. I'm telling you a true story. I don't even think you deny it. No talent. But I go to a studio to do a shot, you know, to do a thing. He would stand outside on the sidewalk waiting for me. Oh, here he comes. He opens my door. I said, does he do this to everybody, to his people? He does it for nobody. Now, who knows? Maybe there was just, but he's waiting for me two or three times. I did a show before this, so now we're going to do a show, I guess, terrible. But I do a show, and he's standing out on Hollywood, whatever, Boulevard, and he's standing there, opening up the door, like, no one came up, no. I was impressed. I was like a guy, right? A guy with potential. And anyone who knew it was my wife, she said, you know. She's very smart. She said, you know there's nobody that can take your place, don't you? I said, thank you, darling, I appreciate it. How smart is that? Now, I don't know if she believes it, but she said, there is nobody that can take your place. He will not be successful. I said, as Arnold Schwarzenegger, he will not be successful. There is nobody, darling, that can take your place. How smart is she? How smart? And she has got a great style. We greeted today the King of Jordan and the Queen of Jordan, and it was like a picture. I watched the three of them. The Queen, the King, and the First Lady, and I stood back. And you know, she had an operation a few weeks ago. Kidney operation, and she didn't be great, which is fine. But they had all kinds of projections. They said she got a facelift. No, I would let you know. They couldn't hide that one for long, right? They said she left me and moved to Virginia. They said she left me and moved to New York. So she moved to Virginia, she moved to New York. The only thing they wouldn't say is what happened, and that's okay. And she's private, she doesn't want to talk about things, right? But really unfair stuff. But you know what? We've never done better than we're doing now. We've never had a time like we have. They put out these horrible polls, and then they hope that everyone's going to say, hey, look, I like Trump, but he's got no chance of winning. Suppression. It should be illegal, actually. You know? You want to check these polls so you know where they're coming from. They do. We had one with ABC, I think it was ABC Washington Post, just before the election. Like a week before, we were down 12. Now, if you're down 12, okay, it's over. Again, thank you, Zelda.